Hi, this is Avril Lavigne, and you can catch me next on The Countdown.
Oh yeah, Avril is here to talk about her video What the Hell and her brand new album Goodbye Lullaby. Plus, Simon Pegg, Kristen Wiig, and Nick Frost are here to tell us about their new. And one more thing, you guys voted for a new number one this week. Will it be Rolling in the Deep from Adele? Will it be Effin' Perfect from Pink? Or did Avril make it here just in time to see What the Hell hit the number one spot? If I told you, I'd ruin the surprise. Oh, yes, it is. It is your VH1 Top 20 Video Countdown for March 12th, 2011. Hello there, everyone. Jim Scheer with your VH1 Top 20 Video Countdown. We have worked our way inside of the Four Seasons in New York City, now hanging out with Avril Lavigne.
What's up?
Thank you for coming.
Thank you for having me. We're just chilling
on
comfy couches.
On comfy couches. Usually yes. I do my interviews on stools. Today we do it in comfort. Congratulations. Your brand new album, Goodbye Lullaby, it is out.
I'm so excited. Thank you.
Now, word on the street is that you did not want this album out until it was done correctly. Is that true?
Well, actually what happened was I've been done this record for a really long time, almost a year. And I've been dying to get it out. And I kind of was going through some stuff with my record company where there was a little push and pull and going back and forth there. But I kind of had to stand my ground a little, but I made the record I wanted to make, and
okay, good.
I'm very proud of it. So,
did your fist ever hit the table?
Oh yeah!
Like, damn it! I want it this way.
A lot of screaming and tears and frustration and hang-ups, but here I am.
But you got it your way.
Yes.
Good. We have what
pretty
the hell
much.
Right now.
Right. No, I'm really proud of this record. I love it.
We have your video. What the hell? Right now on the funometer. If this is zero and this is pegging at 100. How fun was this video to do?
Probably five. It was fun.
All right, because you got to crash a cab.
I got to flirt with a guy.
Many guys.
I got to stage dive. I got to run around LA and be a rock star for 3 days and shoot a music video. So it was fun.
At number three this week, we have your video. Could you introduce it?
I'm Avril Lavigne, and this is my video for What the Hell. You say that I'm messing with your head. Yeah. All 'cause I was making out with your friend. Yeah. Love hurts, whether it's right or wrong. You can save me, baby.
At number three this week, What the Hell?
What the hell?
Avril Lavigne, still hanging out at the Four Seasons in New York City. When you were singing Girlfriend, I heard that you sang that in 8 different languages.
Hey, hey, achete, wa ime ichi ne ne atero shiko hiti o o.
Japanese?
Yeah. Good guess.
Have you done this for What the Hell?
The fun. Means what the hell or what the F in Swedish.
Okay.
And I actually sing it in the background part of the pre-chorus. I go, the fun. And it's just like a little harmony in the background.
Wait, in the regular version?
Yeah.
Oh. World exclusive today.
No one really knows that, so.
So why Swedish?
Because I wrote What the Hell when I was in Sweden with a Swedish producer, Max Martin.
Yes, Max Martin.
And so it was a really funny story. It was, of course, I get to Sweden and I'm like, you know, tell me the bad words. What does this mean? What does that mean? And that's, vafan is one of the first phrases I learn in Sweden, in Swedish. And strangely enough, without even us starting the song, that ended up being the song title, What the Hell. Vafan means like, what the f- what the hell. So it was our working title before we even like really started our song, which is strange, but kind of also
that's
a
awesome.
Cool story. Yeah.
Book came first, then came song.
The title came first, which the title always comes last. And it was just kind of random like that. No intention.
Your album is called Goodbye Lullaby.
Yes.
Since you are here, I want to ask you, what is the theme of this album? Because I listened to the album with my wife, and I thought one thing, she thought another thing.
Well, the theme of
Clear it up for us.
Is about just life and being a human and having ups and downs and personal growth. I'm 26 now, and it's just about moving forward and opening a new chapter in life and finding strength and just growth.
Okay, so opening a new chapter.
Yes.
So there's definitely closure in this album.
I would say so.
There's some doubt in some of the tracks, but then when with the song Goodbye, you're like, all right, she's done. She's off to a new thing in life.
And Goodbye being the last track on the record. It's kind of a bittersweet record. It's a blend of sad and happy emotions, but it has a positive message to it and a good feel throughout it.
Okay, thank you. We will talk more, but we need to take a break. So don't you go anywhere. We have more VH1 Top 20 Video Countdown when we come back. We have returned on your VH1 Top 20 Video Countdown, coming to you from the Four Seasons in New York City, hanging out with Avril Lavigne. I've been waiting to interview you since Complicated. It's happened. Thank you.
10 years later.
I know. It's. I remember, because it was my first year at MTV2, the first time I got to go to the VMAs, you were up on the marquee performing Complicated.
I remember that.
It was many years ago.
Yeah, that was a very exciting year for me.
And please tell me that when you go out on the Black Star Tour, that's what you've decided on, right?
Yes. It's going to be called the Black Star Tour.
I saw the What the Hell TV snippet where you're in that, it looks like a movie theater.
Mm-hmm.
And you're like, do I go with Black Star? Do I go with Lullaby?
Yeah.
You decided on
Black Star.
Black Star.
The fans liked it. I was thinking maybe I'd call the tour like the Lullaby Tour, but then it just felt kind of sleepy.
Right.
So my fragrance is called Black Star, and I have an intro on this record called Black Star. And I thought I just love stars so much. I can play with the image, and the fans can be my little star. Stars out in the audience. So I thought that was kind of a cool title.
But at any point during this tour, will you rock the necktie? Please bring it back for a song.
Not this tour, but I think in the future it'd be kind of cool to like separate each album and like come out and do like a thing where like I rock out on with the first like Skater Boy and Girlfriend or Skater Boy and Complicated, and I have a tie on or something like that. But what's cool about this tour is that I'm going to play like a lot of the new songs from this album, which has a more stripped down feel and vibe to it, and it'll be more acoustic and piano and just like more song driven and intimate. And then I'll also just like rock out to like all the older songs, and so the show will be kind of diverse.
Okay.
Yeah.
Now, if someone were in the audience and tossed a necktie on stage during, say, Complicated, would you wear it around your neck for a second?
Yeah,
and
why
it off
not?
And throw it backstage.
Okay. Yeah, I think I would do that again for fun.
All right,
definitely.
Well, for me, then. Thank you for coming in today.
Thank you.
You will enjoy this song, I'm sure, at number 2 this week, Effin' Perfect. Love the F word, Effin' Perfect.
Why
from
not?
Pink.